If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. We are moving right along with our Neovim configuration, and I have to say, I am really surprised that you guys are enjoying this series, and even though it's something a bit different, I appreciate that I've gotten so much positive feedback about this short series. Even if you guys decide that you don't want to use Neovim, that you're still willing to see what it's about and just come along for the ride. So I just wanted to say thank you for that. That is really appreciated. I'm going to try to make these videos a little bit shorter so that we can tackle one small thing at a time and you don't have to sit through 45 minutes of videos, but hopefully this will make things a little bit easier for you to digest. Today I want to handle a feature that if you do use Sublime or VS Code or anything like that, no matter what IDE or code editor or text editor that you use, is really a handy feature, and that is to be able to search through files so that you can find a file or you can find something within a file. That's what we're going to work on today. To handle this for us, I have been using Telescope, which I have found to be immensely helpful. Telescope is it's a small package, but it does a lot. What does it look like? Well, this is a quick little demo on the Telescope GitHub repo. You can search through a file through here, and then you can also set it up so that you get like a little preview on the right-hand side so that you can see what's actually in that file before you jump to that file. And I think this is a pretty good demonstration of that. The nice thing too is that since we have a color theme, the color theme will be leveraged in here so that we also have some syntax highlighting. And you'll be able to see things a lot clearer. There's also this little icon on the side, so you can also see what kind of files they are before you jump to those files specifically. Let's go down, and we're going to go down to the using lazy Nvim, and that's the one that we can use. So I'm going to go ahead and grab this one because this already has the return in it, and we can create another file in our folder of plugins. So in here, let's go ahead and I'm going to run my alias so that we can get there. And in our Lua designated coder plugins, or that's where mine is, right? I'll just make a new file and I'll call it Telescope. Go ahead into that, paste it in. Let's just clean this up real quick. And that should be good. So let's go ahead, exit out of everything, neoconfig. And as you can see, Lazy is going to go ahead and install that for us. Now, one thing I want to do before we get to that is we have some updates in here, and I think we've had some updates for the last couple of days, the last couple of videos, and I just didn't see it or didn't notice it. To do those updates, we can just go ahead and do Shift U, and that will update all of those packages that we need to update. I like to run this again just to make sure that everything is good, everything has a green ready to go, and it looks like everything is up to date. Queue out of that, we'll go over to our file, and now we have it installed. So good, but we don't have any kind of key mapping to do a search. So let's go back to the documentation and grab some key maps. Now over here, if we take a look at the documentation and go down a little bit, we can also run check health to make sure that our packages are working together. But essentially here are the typical commands that you can use, which will be FF or file finder or find file. You can do FG for live grep. These are how we can set them up inside of Lua and call it a day. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to use mine so that you can see how I have them done, since mine are pretty standard for my use case. So we'll come back to the Neovim, to our configuration file. And I want to open up these dependencies so that we can add some customization in here. Nvim-lua/plenary, that's fine, that's absolutely fine. I'm going to open up another table here. And I want to do nvim-telescope/telescope-fzf/native.nvim. And we're going to run a build command to equal make. So this is going to allow our fuzzy finder to do some really cool things and look really cool doing it. We're also going to add the icons so that we can see them. The little file icons that I showed you earlier, they will have these icons. They're the same. So that's good for that. And then under the dependencies, we're going to do like we've done before, where we're going to create a config variable. And it's going to be a function. and then we'll end it. First, I want to create a local variable. I'll call it telescope, and then it will require telescope. Then I want to create another one called actions, and that will equal require telescope actions. Now, this configuration is going to be very simple. We're just going to have a few things in here, and we are going to use those variables that we have. So here, I'm going to say telescope setup. And then as defaults, we'll open up another table, and then we'll do path display equals truncate layout config will equal, we'll open up another table. We'll say that this is horizontal. Open up another table. And then we'll just do preview cutoff equals zero, which means that our preview, when we open it up, there won't be any cutoff to it. We'll be able to scroll through it. Let me add some commas in here. And then under here, I'm going to do mappings. I believe I is for insert mode. And then we'll add some straight brackets here. And we'll add our first key map, which will be control A. And then we'll say that that equals actions move selection previous. And that'll just move to the previous result as we're searching through. We'll be able to jump through the list of selections in our fuzzy find. I'm going to copy and paste those twice. This will be CJ. This will be move selection next. And this will move to the next result. Control Q will be send selected to QF list plus actions dot open QF list. And that'll just do as it says, send selected to the QF list and actions open QF list. That's all it is, really simple. It's just doing a search and it's putting it in the preview. So let's come under this setup. Now we can do telescope load extension FZF. Or fuzzy fine. Let me move that up a bit so we have a bit more space. Then under here, we can do local keymap. And we'll just say vim.keymap. Kind of like we did with the other plugins where we did vim keymap parentheses and stuff like that. This is just going to be a nice little shortcut for that. That means that here we can do keymap set. And in normal mode, we can do control P. What this will do is this will trigger the search box to open up for us. Do command telescope find files. I'm going to do hidden. And then we'll do the carriage return. You can even give it a description that says, can't see that because of this thing. Fuzzy find files in command. And then let me close off a bracket that I'm missing somewhere. The closing parentheses. And if you look too, as I hover over these, you can see the opening of these, which is really helpful when you're trying to do brackets, when especially if the line is long. I'm going to copy that, paste that two more times. I'm going to actually do it 3 times in total. So again, in normal mode, I am going to use that leader. And if you watch the, I believe it was the setting up lazy, and when we installed Neovim and lazy, we set up this leader key. So for me, it's space. If you're not sure what that means, I would highly recommend going and checking out that video because I go into detail about stuff like this, setting up our options. So this will be space FR. Those are the commands we're going to use. And what are we going to do? We're going to do telescope files, carriage return, and then we'll do fuzzy find recent files. So the next one will be in normal mode again, and this will be FG. I can actually copy this. And this will be for the live grip. This one will just be find string in CWD. So when we have the preview and we're looking for things, then we'll be able to search through that file for a string. That's what FG is. That's a helpful little thing there. And then the last one, will be FC. This will be telescope grep string. Let me get rid of these spaces in here. This one will be find string under cursor in CWD. That's all good. We have our end here. We'll bring this up. And for right now, this is good. So let's save and quit out of that. Let's open that up again and see where I messed up. Name expected near something on 14? I don't know. We'll check. Well, it looks like, first let me add a space here. Not that I need it, that's not the issue, but this defaults here. It's apparently I'm too used to writing JSON files. Or I don't really know what that was about, but hopefully that should clear that up. So let's try it again. So there's another one, unexpected symbol near comma, telescope Lua 38. By 38. I don't think I need these. Okay, there we go. We have telescope working accordingly. Looks like we're bringing in that fuzzy finder, that native in. And full disclosure, I've decided to record this video during a storm, which means power went out, internet went out, so it's kind of stuck where it is. So hopefully it's back up and running now. We'll try to quit out of it. Yeah, because it's reached its timeout. So let's go ahead, try it again. I didn't want to cut this out because I want you to see how things are happening. So hopefully the internet sticks with us while I record this and we can get this going. So we don't have any errors. And now if we do Control P, you can see we have a fuzzy find and we have a preview. And if we go and do Control Up, you can see you can scroll through it. And you can use some of the other commands that we have as well. Now, something to note as well. How do I get out of this? Hit the escape key. Now, something to note is if I go to, well, now that I have this, I can do it. When we're looking at this, if you looked at the video where we did that lazy Vim setup and we made sure to install ripgrep, you wouldn't be able to get this file preview if that's the case. If you didn't have that installed, you wouldn't be able to see this preview. And something else as well is if your screen is really small, the reason I have this line here or these sets of lines here is because if you're working on a virtual machine, then your screen display, your screen resolution might be smaller than your normal regular mode screen, no matter what operating system you're using, your main operating system. So your screen might be too small to be able to see that preview. You may not get it. So for me, in my VMs, I had to put these lines in order to be able to see that preview in that when I had Neovim full screen. That's just a little tip for that. That's just to give you a little bit of an understanding as to why those lines in particular are there. Since we have a Laravel project that we built up in the very first episode of this small series, I want to show you how, let's CD back, and then we have a folder called repos, and we have this testing Neovim. So I want to CD into testing Neovim, and then to open up our Laravel project, just to see what we have working so far. This should look pretty familiar to you. We don't really have any language servers or anything like that, but we do have the icons for the file types. If we go to resources, views, we have the app.blade.php in here, emails, we have the Laravel icons in here. If you go down, you see that we have 5 hidden items. If you try to press enter, you're not actually going to be able to see that. Now, a couple of things we can do. Let's try to search for it. Let's try to search for a .env or even the .env example. That's not showing up. Well, the reason for that is because we kind of have to tell Telescope that that's something that we want to look for. If we go back to our neoconfig and go to the Telescope, go down, and when we are looking for our files, when we're doing the control P for find files, we can actually tell Telescope that that's something that we want to have active within our search. Now, this is something completely optional. It is something that I prefer to do, and just be aware, because it's going to be looking for hidden files, there is going to be a slight performance hit when you try to do a search. But the fuzzy finder that we have installed with it as our extension kind of helps sort of alleviate that a bit. But you will notice a little bit of a lag when you're searching for those hidden files. You will have to decide if this is something that you want to add, but it is something that I've been adding and it works great for me. So hidden equals true. And then no, ignore. Equals true. Save and quit. And let's go back to neoconfig. And as you can see, nothing has changed in here, which is good. But if we go to our Laravel project, we now have these. And if we want to say look for .env, now it shows up in our fuzzy find. Now, if you didn't want to add those commands and have that be part of your search functionality, then you can get back onto this Neotree that we have here. And all you have to do is press Shift H, and that will open up those hidden files for us. You can see all of them now. If we exit out of that, come back, again, those files are hidden, but if you want to see them, Shift H, and those will expose those to us. So that's another option that you can have and still be able to access your hidden files, whether or not you decide to add them to the search. If you're enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button, as it really does help out the channel. Here's a video YouTube thinks you'll like, and here's a playlist to follow along. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.